So good afternoon all. In the previous class, we have discussed regarding the antenna apertures, different types of apertures, aperture concept we have discussed, taking an example of a receiving antenna and its equivalent circuit. We have seen some of the equations and the different types of apertures, effective aperture, scattering, loss, collective and physical. Okay, and for each aperture there is a definition and the equation. Now today let us deal with one of the important concept, relation between directivity and maximum effective aperture. AEM stands for maximum effective aperture and D stands for directivity. So let us see how the relation goes. In order to derive this relationship, this is the figure which we have considered, wherein if this is your antenna side and this shaded part represents the antenna aperture, that too we have considered it effective aperture because we want this value AEM. So if we consider AE, then only we will be able to look at AEM. So this is the AE, effective aperture of an antenna, and this I hope it is visible to all of you, capital E suffix A. Okay, for an antenna the field distribution, and if it is radiating like this, assume this particular part, it is your beam width or beam angle omega A, and at certain distance R we have this field distribution ER. Okay, this is the figure we consider in order to get this relationship. To consider an antenna with the effective aperture which radiates its power in a pattern, this is the pattern, beam width, beam area omega A, assuming a uniform field, that is E suffix A for an antenna over the aperture, ER is the electric field strength, this is the field at some distance R. Okay, and it is perpendicular to the power flow. Okay, if this is the power flow, this will be the direction. We have already seen this in while dealing with the power density concept. P equals to W by A, power radiated divided by A. This P sometimes can be written as S also, and W is equal to P into A. And the power density, we have already seen this. Let me just take it very quickly. It is pointing vector or power density is E cross H. And if you take, it is E into H. Sine theta and sine 90 is 1. And if you take one in terms of the other, it will become E square by 125. Please quickly, you can go through the antenna parameters, power density. You will get this equation. So it is E square by 120 pi. As we have considered the field E suffix A, this field will be EA divided by 120 pi. And the aperture which we have considered for this antenna is AE. So we have substituted accordingly. So mark this as equation 1. Then also the radiated power W is equal to, this I'm talking about similar to this equation. See, this equation has a field 120 pi and AE, and the same radiated power at this field is, instead of EA, take ER square. Okay, the meaning of this is the radiated power at this place is equation 1. However, the radiated power somewhere here at some distance R, okay, we are not talking about this is as the receiving end. No, it is at some distance R in the free space while traveling. What is the power radiated? We are talking about that. So it will be equal to, instead of EA, we will be having ER. Okay. Now, In the next step, you can observe this, we have kept it same. However, the effective aperture has been substituted by this equation. How we got this? It is through the solid angle formula. This we have already seen. It is what? Ds divided by r square, if you remember. While dealing with the beam area, I have taken this. Ds by r square is equal to solid angle. So according to this, Ds is the area. For our antenna figure consideration, it is AE. So AE by r square will be omega A. So from this equation, try to get what is AE. AE will be equal to omega A into r square. So just substitute that. Instead of AE, I have substituted omega A into r square. So this is equation 2. Both equations are for radiated power only. No doubt the positions are different. This power is at here. Okay. One more power is somewhere here. Radiated power. So at both the positions, we have got certain radiated power. Equation 1 and 2. Equate both the things. We will have certain equation. Okay. You can see EA. This first equation, I have kept it as it is at the LHS. And this is the second equation kept at RHS. 125 gets cancelled. Remaining is this as it is. And ER square omega A R square as it is. So mark this as equation 3. Now, what further we can do? If there is a field at some point and at some distance, there is one more field. How these two fields are related, we have a standard formula here. This you will be studying further in the next concepts. The ER value at some distance, whatever field you get, that value, it is equal to the field at this point, okay, into AE divided by R into lambda. This equation, it is the field relationship between both the fields ER and EA. Okay. So what we can do in equation 3, substitute equation 4. Equation 4 is for ER. So in equation 3, you have ER square. Substitute that. If you substitute, say LHS, I have kept it same. RHS omega A into R square kept it same. Instead of ER, this has been substituted. ER square, all terms to be squared. Then if you observe, these two gets cancelled. AE and one value of AE gets cancelled. Remaining is, just take this denominator to the LHS. R square into lambda square equals to one AE is remaining. Lambda into R square. I think one R square will also get cancelled. Yes, R square gets cancelled. AE into lambda A is equal to lambda square. This is the value we get. Now, if we are considering the maximum value of the power transmission, then whatever aperture, effective aperture we have considered from this figure I'm talking about, this AE itself will become your maximum effective aperture. When this aperture will become maximum? When you get the maximum power. The power radiated will be maximum. So in this equation, what all we can modify? AE will become AEM for maximum power transfer condition. Lambda A, keep it as it is. Omega A, and this is your lambda square, kept as it is. Only the difference is, instead of AE, we have substituted AEM, indicating the maximum power transmission. In the previous sessions, we have seen this. We have derived this equation also. Based on this, I have even given you some assignment for sine cube and sine square. D equals to 4 pi by omega A. From this, try to get the value of omega A. It will be 4 pi by D. So instead of this, substitute omega A. It is 4 pi divided by D. I substituted that 4 pi divided by D, AEM as it is, lambda square as it is. So what will be Aem? Aem equals to lambda square divided by 4 pi into D. Or you can try getting the equation for D. D equals to Aem into 4 pi divided by lambda square. Somehow, either you take the equation for Aem or take the equation for directivity, because the heading is what? Relation between directivity and Aem. Okay. So how we got that final equation? We started with this. We took some electric field distribution at the antenna side Ea, and at some distance r, Er is the distribution. Omega A is your beam width. Ae is your effective aperture. From we started with this figure, we equated the equations 1 and 2, radiated powers. Then we have a standard relation for the fields which are at a distance from one another. This is the relation. This relation we have substituted in equation 3. Finally, for Ae, we replaced it with Aem because of the maximum power transfer. Then for substitution of directivity value, from this equation we got beam width. Finally, the relation between Aem and D. Either you represent the equation LHS Aem or the LHS directivity. I think this formula is better to remember. D equals to 4 pi by lambda square into Aem. Easy to remember. I hope you understood this. Any doubts, you can ask me. Else, I'll move to the next topic. Shall I move? Any doubts, please put it in the chat box. Okay. Fine. Moving to the next topic, it is maximum effective aperture and directivity value. What we have derived here, this is the relationship. Now we want to see the actual values of some practical antennas, Aem and D values. How we know now how they are related. Okay. Now we will see what are the values for these two parameters for some antennas. First type of antenna is a short dipole antenna. Please go through your Google Classroom. I have sent some information regarding this. Please go through it, okay? Okay, you can observe here. This is a short dipole, okay? Dipole, di means two, pole, two ends are there, okay? It looks like this. Two poles are there. This is the feeder line from where the power is fed. Okay. The same thing horizontally kept here is taken. This is the practical short dipole antenna. This looks good and colorful. Okay. I'll send you the image also. Now, what is a short dipole? Short dipole is a dipole antenna, dipole types of antenna, which are having two poles, whose length, this total length, what I have marked here, L, small l, this length of the wire, it is shorter than the wavelength. If you are having the wavelength lambda, and if L is the length of the wire, length of the antenna, then this length will be always smaller than the wavelength. If such condition is met, we call it a short dipole antenna. In order to get this values, see what is the thing? We need to find the Aem value, right? Aem is equal to, and then directivity. Once we get Aem value, just by using this relationship, we can find D also. No problem. Now, we will look at how to get this maximum effective aperture. In order to get this, just let's go back to the antenna apertures. We will see what is the value of Aem we got. effective aperture is this, then maximum effective aperture value is Aem equals to V square by 4P RR. So we will make use of this equation. Okay. This is the figure under consideration. A plane wave is incident on a short dipole. Antenna is kept like this along y direction. And if you see, the direction of the incident wave is towards minus x direction. Okay, this is the feeder line. Okay, incident wave is in this direction. The wave is assumed to be linearly polarized. Now, I think you have studied interference, diffraction, and polarization, three concepts in physics. Under that, there are three different types of polarizations you might have studied: linearly polarized, circular polarized, and elliptical polarization. Three different polarization I think you have studied. But still, if you are not getting this linearly polarized, please, I have put the figure, okay, GIF, even in WhatsApp I have sent you how this linearly polarized wave is shown in the diagram. I have sent that. Please go through it. It is not any descriptive answer. Some image is there. Just look at the image. It will not even take two minutes of time to analyze. Okay. You'll understand what is the meaning of linearly polarized. So here, whatever wave we have considered, it is assumed to be linearly polarized with E, that is field, in y direction. Field is in y direction, means the wave in which the wave, how it is traveling, it has got, you know, it's a combination of all different electric and magnetic fields. So how the field is, it is in the y direction. That is the consideration. Then the current I on the dipole, it is assumed to be constant. So there is not much of, you know, thinking about the current. It's a constant term. Now the terminal resistance RT, here I have used RR. If you remember, when we were dealing with the antenna aperture, I have used some different resistances, RT, then RR and RL, right? These two were at the antenna side. This was at the load side, okay? And this load side, whatever resistance RT, terminal resistance is there, that is assumed to be same as that of RR. Okay, with this condition, loss resistance, we have assumed it zero. These both are equal, and this RL is equal to zero. So this is about the figure and the considerations. Incident wave direction is along minus x direction, but the field created will be in y direction. RR equals to RT. There is no loss of resistance. RL is equal to zero. Current is constant. And the length of this short dipole is small l. Okay. With this, we know that this formula we have already seen while dealing with the effective aperture. Aem equals to V square by 4P RR. Now what we will do, this is the reference equation for us. How many unknowns are there here? V, P and RR. There are three unknowns. We will try to substitute the values for these three in order to get the final equation. Okay. First, let's start with the V. The induced voltage V, it is given by the product of effective electric field intensity and its length. How we got this? We have, you know that already, I guess. The electric field is equal to voltage induced divided by the length. So V will be equal to E into L. Okay? Physics, while dealing with the electric field intensity, you might have studied this. V equal to E into L. This is one value we got. This is over. Then what is P? Not P, here I have taken RR first. Let's take RR first. So RR is the radiation resistance of an antenna. In further concepts, you have this for your syllabus. For a short dipole, the RR value is given by Rr equals to 80 pi square L by lambda whole square. This is the Rr value, just like you know that impedance is equal to 370 ohm you have taken, right? So similar to that, Rr for a short dipole is 80 pi square L by lambda square. Actually it is I average by I naught also. Both are equated here so that the value you get is this Rr. So this is the standard value. This derivation you have it for your syllabus. So V square, V is done, Rr is done. We are left with P. P is the power density. So let's move. We know this already. Power density is given by E cross H, which is E into H, or E square by 120 pi. This is the equation for power density. So now we have got equation 2, 3 and 4. One is for V, one is for Rr, one is for power density. All these three values substitute in Aem equation. Let's substitute. Substituting the values, Aem equals to V square, E square by E square into L square, divided by 4 as it is. P, 4P, P is E square by 120 pi into Rr, 80 pi square L by lambda square. Now, just simplification further, what all you can do? E square terms gets cancelled, then 1 pi gets cancelled, 4 ones are, 430s are, 0, 0 cancels, then L square gets cancelled. You will be left with denominator value is 3. So this 3 goes to the numerator. Here denominator, because this is at denominator of the denominator, it comes to numerator. Then here denominator 8, it is as it is. Then this is also denominator of the denominator, it comes to the numerator. And 1 pi value is left, 8 pi. So this is how the the terms gets cancelled and you'll be left with this. You can calculate the value of 3 by 8 pi, it comes around 0.119. You can calculate, you can take your time and calculate and check 3 by 8 pi. What is the value? You will get it as 0.119 lambda square. You want to calculate it? If you want to calculate, you can. Just confirm it. Did you calculate? Shall I proceed? Fine. 3 by 8 pi equals to 0.119. Lambda square, we don't know the wavelength specifically, so keep it as it is. So this is about Aem. But the heading is, we have to find for a short dipole type of antenna, both maximum effective aperture as well as directivity also. Right, so now we have got Aem. Let's try to find the directivity. How to find? Just now we have calculated, we have seen this is the relationship between Aem and directivity. So make use of this formula and find D. D equals to 4 pi by lambda square into Aem. Use that formula. D equals to 4 pi by lambda square into Aem. Keep this as it is. Instead of Aem, I have not used this. I have used this so that terms gets cancelled. 3 by 8 pi lambda square. Okay, what all terms gets cancelled? Pi gets cancelled. Lambda square will go. Then it is 3 by, 4 ones are, 4 twos are. So it is 3 by 2, which is equal to 1.5. So the directivity of short dipole is 1.5 and the maximum effective aperture for a short dipole is 0.119 lambda square. Now, how the question will be tricked? The question will be either find the maximum effective aperture and directivity for a short dipole, a straightforward question, or prove that the short dipole AEM is equal to 0.119 lambda square, or instead of giving you 0.119, they'll give you 3/8 pi lambda square, okay, just to confuse you. So for a short dipole, remember how the figure is, how we started this derivation. If you remember, you can finally arrive at this equation. We started with this dipole kept in along the y direction, taking the length L. This is the incident wave direction. Field is in a y direction. Current is constant and RT is equal to RR. Keeping this figure for a reference, we have seen AEM is equal to V square by 4PRR. There are three unknown terms here. All the three values we will see, we will get the equations for this one and this one. After that, all those three equations we substitute in one. Then we get AEM value. So once we get AEM, make use of the relationship between directivity and AEM. Find the value of D. I hope this is understood. Any doubts, please ask me. Point 119, okay. Understood? This is a simple derivation. Just you need to understand the figure, okay? If you understand the figure, remaining all will fall in place. Okay, shall I continue? I will just give you this introductory part of this and then we will continue, okay? In this section, we have studied first the relationship and then this title, maximum effective aperture of and directivity of a short dipole, okay? Short dipole, it's a type of dipole antenna whose length is shorter than the wavelength. Now, similar to this concept, we have maximum effective aperture and directivity of lambda by 2 antenna. What's the difference in the earlier case and here? In the earlier equation, what we have seen, and the type of antenna is a short dipole where the length is lesser than the wavelength. Here it is specifically given that the length is lambda by 2. It is also called half wave dipole. Okay, half wave is what? Lambda by 2. So L length is half of the wavelength. Okay, it's also a type of short dipole only. But because length is less than lambda by 2, less than the lambda. So for this also, what we will do, we'll have one figure consideration. With that figure consideration, we will take the reference of maximum effective aperture equation, which we have already seen in the effective aperture part. AEM equals to V square by 4PRR. Then we have three unknowns, V, P and RR. We will try to substitute for these three values. And then finally, from the equation 1, we will be getting AEM value. Okay, we will do this. It is similar to your short dipole antenna. Only a little bit difference. The voltage value, the voltage induced, that value will differ. In earlier, it was very much straightforward E into L because we had considered length as the, E into L. The distribution of electric field was constant, okay? There was not much difficulty in earlier case. But here in lambda by 2 antenna, we have to consider the current distribution as well. Current in earlier case was assumed to be constant. But here in the second example, the current distribution is not same. If you observe, see the diagram remains looks like the same, right? This is the image which I have taken from the net, just to show you how the lambda by 2 antenna looks like. The length is lambda by 2. This is the feeder element. It looks the same. Now, earlier case, current was constant, I. But here if you see, current is not constant. It is distributed in the form of a sine wave. This is half sine, okay? Sine wave. So, because of this, earlier current distribution was constant. Hence, it was simply V equal to E into L. Directly we have taken, then RR, then P. We substituted directly. But in the second one, as the distribution is not uniform, current distribution, it is in form of a sine wave, V will change. The induced voltage will change. Remaining two value, let's see what will happen. And finally, we will arrive at Aem. Okay. Will you try this? No doubt I will be solving this in the next session. But will you try? Will you try getting this Aem value for lambda by 2 antenna? At least try. I don't want the correct exact answer. Will you try? Hopefully you will try. Even if you don't try, I have to take this session anyhow. But let's see, if you have done, you can just message me, okay? You can please put a message of your answer. Take the photograph and let me see how many of you are able to solve it, okay? Any doubts in today's class? If you have any doubts, please ask me. I'll clarify, I'll try to clarify. No, okay. I hope no doubts for everyone. Or many doubts, lot of doubts. Okay, we will continue tomorrow. Probably I'll be taking the class tomorrow. I have actually 4th hour. Let's see.